spoken energy. Now, the country's power situation is likely to experience a hiccup by 2015 if investment in the sector is intensified towards the development of thermal plants in the country. Acting Chief Executive of the Volta River Authority, Ker Kofi, has explained the hydro plants are no longer reliable for the supply of power due to erratic rainfall patterns. Sandra Makwe has more. At 1,900 megawatts, culminating into an annual growth of 10%, already Ghana is losing 132 megawatts from T3 thermal plant and 80 megawatts from the Tema thermal plant due to the shutdown of both plants. Erratic rainfall pattern this year has resulted in a 10-meter fall in Akonsombo's water level, threatening to reduce the 1,020-megawatt supply. VRA for now is able to meet the country's demand despite these challenges. VRA, however, fears an unstable power supply by 2015 if investments are not made towards the development of thermal plants.
The hydro level is low because the inflow this year, we only had 60 MEF, had close to about 4 feet rise, which is not enough. The level today can take us next year. And then if the inflow next year is also not as good as this year, our challenge as VRA is 2015 and not 2014. We need between 150 and 200 megawatts of thermal generation to meet 2015 demand.
Delay in the purchase of crude oil by government for VRA has disrupted power supply in the past due to low tariffs. Though not satisfied with the tariff adjustment by PURC at 78%, VRA is hopeful government will pay its promised for subsidy on time to boost operational activities. The completion of Ghana Gas Project by first quarter of 2013 is expected to also ease the pressure on the purchase of gas from Nigeria.
Today, the tariffs are not enough because I'm spending a lot of crude oil. If we get the full supply of Nigerian gas, full supply of Ghana gas, I believe we should be able to break even with today's tariff.
Ker Kofi explains VRA intends to partner more independent power producers to build thermal plants.